right, 25 minutes before 10 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this very autumn-like Wednesday morning. Laura Burns is in the studio. We had that's an inside joke. She's saying it's not autumn-like at all. Well, you grew up in Seattle, so let's... Laura is here, of course, from CareerSource, and she's the communications manager at CareerSource in Levy, Citrus, and Marion counties.
That's right.
Plural. And you've brought a couple of guests, Jeff Duncan and Pam Falenga. And Jeff, you are the director of operations for American Panel. Is that right?
American Panel Corporation. That's correct.
All right. And you've got some job openings we're going to learn about?
We do. We do have some job openings.
And Pam Falenga, you're a human resources director for, same company, American Panel. Well, you work
that's
together.
Correct.
All right. Well, thank you both for coming in. Where is American Panel?
Out on Baseline Road, just south of the landfill.
And what kind of paneling do you make?
Make walk-in coolers and freezers. For restaurants, hotels, just about anything you can think of. We've done anything from morgues to anything else.
So. Really? How big is the one in the morgue?
Some are fairly small. Some are a little bit larger.
Really?
Depending on how...
Need a big one when I die.
How many clients they have, so...
Yeah, how many bodies in a morgue cooler?
It varies. The one up in the VA in Gainesville, they had a couple in there when I went to check out their walk-in. But
I don't want to see that.
Yeah, it wasn't too much fun.
I've seen them in movies, but yeah. So that's what you make, huh?
We do.
So where does the word panel come in? I'm confused.
Panels, all our walk-in coolers are made out of sectional panels that lock together and form a walk-in cooler or freezer.
Is this like a secret in Ocala, Laura?
I will tell you that it is probably one of the best-kept secrets, although I don't know why. The incredible number and variety of manufacturers that we have in Marion County, and of course we've got two new ones coming in. If you read the Star Banner this morning, we're very excited about those. And gosh, it's just amazing to know what is manufactured right here in our backyard that get shipped all over, frankly, all over the world.
Oh, wow. So how many people work there?
I think right now we have 200 plus. I think Pam was telling me 210 employees currently.
Okay.
So.
And does it run the gamut as far as like floor sweeper to scientist?
Absolutely. We've got engineers to manufacturing employees to office employees. HR and accounting and the full gamut of types of employees that we have.
Now, and when you do a walk-in cooler, let's say for a restaurant. Mm-hmm. Do you build it and then how does it get in there? They're bigger than any door.
Well, most of the panels are going to be max of about 4 foot wide and 8 foot 6 tall. And although we do make a lot larger warehouse walk-ins as well, but they come in and panelize sections and it gets installed inside the restaurant or facility that it's going into.
Wow, I never knew. And you, what area do you serve? The whole country?
Actually, I would consider us international, although most of the international outside the U.S. stuff that we do is Central, South America, Caribbean, stuff like that. We don't do a whole lot in Europe or Asia. They have their own manufacturers over that way, but we do a decent amount in definitely the Caribbean, some in Central and South America as well.
And are there positions at your company that actually goes with the panels to install them on the long distance sales?
No, a long time ago when we were based out in Miami, we did have our own install crews that did some local installs, but most of it's done by a local refrigeration contractor who does the install in each site.
Wow. So is it Laura has taught me the word, the culture of a company, right? What is the corporate culture? Is it like a factory? Is it like an office or a mixture?
It's a mixture of both. We do have an office. We got a 100,000 square foot facility. And then we just bought 40,000 square feet a couple years ago across the road from us and redid that as well. So we've got about 140,000 square feet now. We do have office and plant manufacturing facility, and I would consider, we're a family-owned company. My family, actually.
You look like you could be in my family.
Yeah.
Doesn't it kind of resemble my family? Laurent knows some of my family.
Yeah.
We're a 52-year-old company. My grandfather started it. Uh-huh. Dad runs it now, and you know, I'll be, my sister and I will be the next next wave there. So
is Pam your sister?
No.
No, okay. No. I thought I saw you nod. No. I thought, okay.
No, I know this.
But you knew it already. Okay.
Right.
Well, Pam, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
you. Now, you're the one we come to if we want to work, right?
That's correct.
Okay. So what kind of jobs, or what kind of positions do you have right now?
We have a lot of positions available, and I'm going to highlight just a few of them.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
We have an inside sales associate position, and that sales associate takes customer specifications that are sent to us from our customers, and they will develop a price and provide the customer with a price. So it's more like an estimating
position. This is a customer, when you say inside sales, that person deals with somebody who's already interested?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. Usually it's marketing agents or equipment dealers that are trying to get equipment for a restaurant, hotel, prison, hospital, a large application commercial.
Okay.
And the requirements for that particular job, now all our jobs, we look for people that are self-motivated and generally have a positive outlook on life in general and excel in a team environment. Up and above that, though, there are certain job requirements. So for the sales associate, we require somebody that has good math skills, good computer skills, communication skills. It is a customer service-oriented role. Mm-hmm. So we require somebody that has an outgoing personality, and a college degree is definitely preferred.
Okay, preferred, okay.
Right.
But if somebody's been around a while and they just never went to college, but they've kind of
have everything else,
fit the bill,
especially the positive outlook on life in general, then self-motivated, we would consider them, absolutely.
Yeah, those are good qualities for any job, really. I mean, if you're looking for work, you got to be a self-motivator.
Absolutely. Just,
I think, and no matter what you do. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's one position.
Okay.
Do we want to talk salaries, or is that left behind closed doors, or how does that work?
I think that basically
Laura
works.
Laura grimaced. I'm looking at Laura for feedback.
It was sort of a smile. You know, that's part of the, you know, the interview and negotiating.
Okay,
process.
So we don't talk about that here? Okay. Just curious.
Unless you want to.
Is it more than minimum wage?
Yes, it is. It pays a lot of money.
Oh, it pays a lot of money. That's all they want
to
hear.
Very competitive.
No, I'm serious. I mean, there's somebody listening right now, I hope, that is saying, gosh, this sounds good to me. Tell me how much it pays. That's what I would be asking.
Right. We have a lot of things off American Panel, and great wages is one of them.
Okay.
So it is a salary position, which has its benefits, and also there's a small commission that goes with it.
Okay. All right. That's excellent. You said you had more than one?
We do. We have three other positions I wanted to talk about today.
Okay.
Actually, it's more than three, because the first one I'm going to talk about is our general production positions.
Ah.
We have three shifts. We have a first shift, a second shift, and a third shift.
Oh, you're a 24-hour facility?
Correct.
Oh,
24-6.
Wow.
We don't work Sundays, but right now we are working Monday through Saturdays.
Okay. What time does the last shift get off before Sunday starts?
The last shift gets off before Sunday starts, 7 p.m.
7 p.m. Oh, this on Saturday evening?
Correct.
Oh, that's great.
Correct.
Oh,
correct.
That is great. That way, so the first shift from Monday actually starts 7 p.m. Sunday?
Starts at 10 o'clock p.m. on Sunday night.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So it's third shift runs 10 p.m. to 7 on Sunday.
Well, that's wonderful. I mean, that mm-hmm. leads to a good culture, don't you think?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And the Saturday work is not something that's all year round. We've had actually a extremely busy summer. We're having, last year we had our best year ever. This year we're on track to definitely eclipse that. So, you know, we've been running a lot of overtime lately, so we've got a lot of guys that are, you know, happy in one sense that they're making a little overtime pay, unhappy that they're you know, having to work some Saturdays, but we do have a ton of work to get out the door, and we are really we're very happy with the sales and things that we've got going on at American Panel
now. So how do you keep your hand on the pulse of what is going on with your personnel?
You know, it's really...
Are you with them a lot? You kind of walk around?
Oh, absolutely.
Hang out, yeah.
Absolutely. You know, we know, like I said, it's a family company. We are very involved with our employees. We've got a great amount of employees that have been with us for 20 years plus. We got some 30-year plus guys. We got some guys that came with us from Miami. We moved the company from Miami up here in 1983.
Did they like the move?
Some of them, absolutely. Yeah. You know, Miami was getting at
a
that time.
Culture shock.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. But it was getting crowded at that time. So and we moved it up here to Ocala, you know, a little better standard of living, I guess you could say.
Oh, that's nice.
So
I hope they realized it.
Absolutely. So and we do offer benefits to all our employees as well. You know, that is one of all our medical benefits are all paid by the company.
Oh, wow.
For all our full-time employees. So that is one of the benefits they get when they come to American Panel. So we've got a lot of employees that have been with us for a long time, and they've our guys this summer, especially guys and girls, I guess I should say, they've done a great job this summer, especially because it has been a hard, hot summer, and really a lot of overtime, and they've hit it gung ho and really really pushed the product out the door, and we're very happy to give them some kudos as
do
well.
Do you give tours?
Absolutely. See, you know, certain people, absolutely, for you. You know, we
so I want to see what it looks like.
Absolutely, you know, we've got a great manufacturing facility. We really do.
Do you have a website?
www.americanpanel.com.
Okay, I'll look at it later on.
Yeah.
Looking at it. So tell me about some of the other jobs.
Okay, Pam? General production positions, as I mentioned, openings on all three shifts, and they're mostly in assembly.
And what does that guy do, or girl?
Well, we have shuttles or presses where we make the individual panels into. So first we cut and bend all of the metal. It's in our metal fabrication department. And then it goes to the assembly department where they assemble the metal along with tooling according to the drawings, what size the panel needs to be, whether it's a floor, a wall, a ceiling, a door, a corner, or a tee. They assemble it there, and then we use a foam injection process to make the panels.
And that's what keeps it cool inside?
That's what insulates it, yes. Okay. That's what keeps the cold air inside. Correct. So we have openings in all three shifts. Requirements for those, basic requirements other than the, you know, self-motivation, initiative, enthusiasm type things, they need to be able to read a tape measure, lift and carry heavy objects, and all of the jobs require a lot of standing and walking for the production.
Wow,
jobs.
That sounds like something a lot of people could. And that one requires no college or yes?
No, it doesn't require any college. We prefer experience. Construction experience is helpful, or manufacturing experience. But we'll even employ, you know, people that have the positive attitude if they can meet those other things with no experience at all.
Can I tell you just? I'm going to tell you something just so I can ask a question. It's kind of off the track a little bit. When I was a kid in New York, I worked at a sheet metal factory, and we were bending things with the machines then. And I didn't want to do it at all because I wanted to do something where I was with people, not with machines. And I often wondered, I wonder what that factory looks like now. I mean, we're talking 40-something years ago. I mean, back then it was, I pushed a button, let it do its thing, and then pushed the button and let it do its thing, and literally did that for 8 hours. Is it less mundane now? Is our computers doing the mundane stuff?
Absolutely. We have a lot of computerization in our factory. A lot of things that used to be a lot of manual labor back in high school and college, in between summers, I used to work out in the factory, and some of the things that we used to do by hand are now all done by machines. Just greatly affects the efficiency of the plant and what we're able to move through and get out. It's amazing. You know, and like you said, you've got some experience, so you're qualified. Come apply.
I was going to say, you need a part-time job.
Do you have part-time jobs?
We typically prefer to hire full-time, but we do full-time. Have some part-time people that have worked there for a while.
You have to be able to lift and read a tape measure. Mm-hmm. That's pretty reasonable. I mean, how many positions that fit that description are available?
Probably between 8 and 10 right now.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hello? Anybody need a job?
We just implemented a new piece of equipment that increased our panel production, so we need more people to staff that on all three shifts. So,
if you're listening to this and this is not for you, like somebody you know could be interested in this whole interview is being recorded. Share this with somebody. It'll be on our site by 2 this afternoon. We'll continue with our conversation. Jeff Duncan and Pam Falenga are here from American Panel. They make walk-in coolers, walk-in freezers, every size from restaurant to morgue. and we're going to find out more about how you can get a job with them. Laura Burns, of course, is here from CareerSource, and I'm guessing that's the avenue that our listeners need to take.
Sir.
Go through CareerSource. So we'll take our little break, and let me think, I missed it. I got to go back to it. We'll be right back. This is WOCA.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. For today, mostly cloudy with a couple of showers and heavier thunderstorms in the area, high 84 to 88. Mostly cloudy tonight with a shower and thunderstorm around, mainly early, low 69 to 73. A blend of sun and clouds tomorrow with an afternoon thunderstorm in spots, high 86 to 90. And for Friday, a bit cooler with clouds, some sun, and a shower or thunderstorm in the afternoon, high 81 to 85. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Let's face it. Nowadays, it can be hard to find American-made products, and that's something that Cabinet Sales of North Florida is well aware of. That's why they're an authorized dealer of Wellborn Cabinetry, family-owned and American-made since 1961. Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your answer for complete turnkey kitchen remodels and whole house cabinetry. Their cabinets are finished with solvent-based enamels for a long-lasting finish that's second to none. Available in an incredible selection of door styles and colors to choose from to turn your dream kitchen into a reality. In-house design and drawing services are available. Come by and see our displays for yourself at the Floors of the Villages, 3935 County Road 216 in Oxford, or Exquisite Design Kitchen and Bath in Bellevue, right across the street from the Bellevue Library. So whether you're looking for bookcases, kitchen, bath, or outdoor kitchen, Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your one-stop source of quality cabinets. For a free estimate, call 352-427-2647. That's 352-427-2647. Cabinet Sales of North Florida.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roof line and a new spoiler and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
All right. We're having a great conversation even off the air. Jeff Duncan is here. Pam Falanga is here. Pam is the Human Resources Director for American Panel. She is the person you'll probably speak to after you speak to Laura Burns over at CareerSource. And Jeff is the Director of Operations. You're the boss. You're the...
I wouldn't call myself the boss.
How come bosses don't ever want to admit that they're the boss?
Yeah.
But
it's the word boss. were you? Did you grow up in the video game era? Yeah. You always have to kill the boss. That's why nobody wants to be a boss anymore.
Exactly.
Nobody wants to be a boss.
Exactly.
And Laura Burns, of course, is here. And Laura, we would come to you at CareerSource if we were interested in any of these jobs, right?
Well, you wouldn't come to me, but you would go to
you guys.
You would go to our website, CareerSourceCLM.com, and go to our calendar of events. If you click on today's date, you'll see the WOCA AM Ocala Live with American Panel, and then that will describe, provide the job order numbers and how you can apply. So you can go right through that because you will be applying through the Employee Florida Marketplace, which is the online job board tool that we use and all the workforce development regions use in Florida right now. So that's the most efficient way to apply for these positions. So just go to our website, and that should be up this afternoon. By the same time the podcast is available, we'll get that up for you.
You know, I don't know how to calculate how much more a job is worth to an employee when you have benefits added to it, how much, like if you could figure out the dollar amount. But can you go through that? It sounds like you've got some really good benefits. Can you talk about them?
We do. We have great reasons to work at American Panel, and they start with the leadership from the owner to the lead person on the floor. They're great to work with, and we have a great working environment. We have a clean factory. Everything's organized. Everybody has the tools that they need to do their jobs, and we consider safety a priority. We also have a lot of recognition programs. For example, our employees are recognized via an Employee of the Month and an Employee of the Year program. And we have that ongoing throughout the year. And I wanted to take this opportunity, too, is to mention what Jeff did. This year, our employees have really stepped up their game. And if they're listening out here, we just want them to know that we are very proud of them and that we appreciate them and that these programs are for them because of their hard work. We also have things like incentives where if an employee goes for 10 years without an absence, they get a trip to anywhere in the continental United States.
That would be me. I've never called in sick.
We have so many people that have.
Joe, I need a trip anywhere. In the continent.
Come work us for us for 10 years and for 20 years. And we have one person who already achieved this. And I think either this year or next year we'll have two more. You get a trip anywhere within reason. We're not going to send them to the moon. But they can go. They get 10 days off.
They might need a walk-in refrigerator.
Exactly. If they pay enough, we'll do it. But they also will get 10 days off with pay plus spending money. So we have a lot of great things like that. We have a tuition reimbursement program, a suggestion program. We have a scholarship program for children of American Panel employees in honor, established in honor of Jeff's and Jenny, his sister's grandparents, Marvin and Olga Duncan, where we give the children $1,000 to help them go to college.
Two of those each year. We have our employees, if they have a child that's going on to college, they can apply for our scholarships, and we do $2,000 scholarships each year.
Correct. You need a reality show.
I would love it.
Wouldn't that be cool? You were mentioning during the break that the walk-ins are visible on some well-known shows.
Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of the Food Network stuff out there. If you look in the background, you always see a walk-in in a kitchen somewhere. But if you look closely, you can see our logo. One of the ones on it. Probably shouldn't. Well, we're going to mention it anyway. Wahlburgers.
Yeah.
Because they're not a sponsor.
Now I want to watch the show.
But Wahlburgers is a show. And I think that one's on A&E or History Channel, something like that. And almost every episode of theirs, if you look in the background, there is an American Panel walk-in almost every show that you see there. But also a lot of the Food Network shows, the Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives and things like that. You end up seeing our walk-ins a lot in the background of these shows.
Wow. And I'm going through my mind. And how many walk-ins I've actually been in. Mm-hmm. I worked at an assisted living facility. There was a freezer and a refrigerator that you had to walk in. Mm-hmm. And I was in, I used to work at the Holiday Inn. Again, a young job as a dishwasher. I used to have to walk in there.
Absolutely.
I think it was cool. The big plastic strips that come down.
Absolutely. Strip curtains, yeah.
So tell me more jobs.
Okay. Well, and to finish up with the benefits, as Jeff mentioned, we do offer free health insurance for employees. We have actually
free
health insurance.
Oh, health insurance.
Health insurance, okay. No cost.
We pay 100%. That makes your job worth more.
Right, and we take, a lot of employees take advantage of that. We offer more programs that you could pay for, but it's a good program through Blue Cross and Blue Shield. We have dental, life, vision. We have holidays. We have vacation. We have
so you have great teeth. Is that why?
Hmm?
You have great teeth, pretty teeth.
Thank
you both got nice teeth.
Oh, thank you.
Laura, you got nice teeth too.
So those are some of the benefits that we apply. Obviously, I don't want to go into all of them, but it is a great place to work because of the wages, because of the jobs, because of the benefits. And I wanted to talk about, we have two more jobs, actually, that I wanted to talk to you about today. And one is a refrigeration assemblers. We make blast chillers in the new facility that we have called 6161, and we need people to assemble and test refrigeration units, customized refrigeration units. So, the requirements for those jobs are knowledge of refrigeration. You must be able to read an electrical schematic, and we prefer that the employee have an EPA certification so that they can handle refrigerant.
Could that be somebody who had worked for an air conditioner company?
Absolutely. Okay. We have a lot of people that are tired of working out in the ducts and outside and various schedule. This is a Monday through Friday, Saturday type situation, 7 to 3:30, indoor, great wages, good benefits. And so we get a lot of people from that industry. Also people that just graduated school, could do that. Because we train, all these positions we train, we do hands-on training with them.
Wow. Any office-related work?
Pardon?
Any office-related work?
Just the office. Right now, the only position we have right now is a sales associate
for
the office.
Okay, all right.
And then the last position is a maintenance mechanic. It's our third shift.
Oh, okay.
So, and that is a great position as well. We both have first and second shift staffed fully right now, so we need someone to support our third shift, and that's for general building maintenance and maintenance on our equipment.
And does that include the equipment that has been already delivered and installed?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
That would be equipment that we use to manufacture the walk-ins.
Oh, I see.
Right.
But if you install a walk-in and it needs maintenance for some reason, is that the responsibility of the buyer?
It depends. Depends on the situation. Some of it is the responsibility of the buyer. Some of it would be our responsibility as well. But what we usually do there is we send out a local service tech in whatever area it may be, whether it be local here or or around the country.
I know. I'm up against the clock. You always bring in such great guests.
I know. The time flies, right, but yeah. I want to just jump in here just briefly for a little infomercial. We have three job fairs coming up. These are opportunities. One is going to be right here at the mall for seasonal retail hires. That's going to be on September 24th.
Okay.
We have an all-industry job fair at the college at the Klein Center on October 1st. And then we have another fall job fair over at CF La Canto on October 15th. And if you're an employer and you want to get in on any of these, give us a call at 1-800-434-5627. If you are a job seeker, go to our website for a calendar of events and find out more. So free of charge for all.
Good stuff. Career Source is where you would go for any of the jobs, including the ones that you just heard about today. Give me that number again, Laura.
Well, the website is Career Source.
Oh, just go to the website.
Yeah, okay. CareerSourceCLM.com.
CareerSourceCLM. Jeff Duncan and Pam Falenga, thank you both for coming
Absolutely.
In today.
Thank you.
Fascinating. I want to take a tour.
Absolutely. Come on by.
Yeah, I'll have to see it. Thank you all for coming in.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
And enjoy the fall weather.
Yes.
We will.
We'll be right back. This is The Source, WOCA.
Today in Florida Ag News from the Southeast AgNet, while Congress is in Washington, there are only a few weeks left before they return to the campaign trail in October. Gary Adams, Vice President of Economics and Policy Analysis.